Bling Crew, welcome back to our channel. It is Shannon, and today I'm going to show you how to make one of the most requested tumblers, a three-color ombre tumbler in a honeycomb pattern. We created a printable template for you so that it's easy to follow along, and you'll be creating this three-color ombre for yourself in no time. This is a printable pattern that you can follow along with, and I'll leave a link below to our website where you can find it and print it out for yourself. Then I'm going to be using one of our rhinestone tumbler kits. The tumbler kit has everything you need to get started and to make this three-color ombre tumbler. It has super tight fusion tack. It also comes with three rhinestone shaker trays that make it simple and easy to flip up your rhinestone so they're ready to pick up. Then it also has a rhinestone shovel that this makes it easy to pick up your rhinestones as well. There's also two wax tip rhinestone pickup tools. You will need a pencil sharpener to sharpen these. Then to apply the glue, it has a 5 ml syringe, and it also comes with two 20 gauge blunt tip needles. Then there is 10 containers in here with screw top lids, so it's convenient for storing your rhinestones and so that you can put them away and you're not going to spill them. Then there is 60 gross of rhinestones included with the kit. There is three different colors, and each of the colors has 10 gross of the size SS20, so that's split between two of the containers. And then there is the size SS16 that comes in one container. And then this kit has the colors Chameleon Rainbow, then Peridot, and then the color Crystal. So the average tumbler, if you're doing a honeycomb pattern, takes about 30 gross of rhinestones. So there is enough stones in this kit to actually make two tumblers. The kit also includes a 20-ounce skinny tumbler, and the container that it comes in has these removable dividers, so you can pull them out, you can rearrange them, you can arrange them in ways however you want to keep your stones in the container, or if you have larger stuff, you can move them around to keep them in there as well. And then the kit is available on our website, blingyourthings.com. You do save over $15. Purchasing the kit compared to purchasing everything individually. So let's go ahead and get started working on the template. So you can find the printable template on our website, blingyourthings.com. I did go ahead and already start this tumbler. I've prepped it, I sanded it, I cleaned it with alcohol, and then I started on the template. I completed the first half and then the second color as well. So this template has three different colors, and the template it's referenced as A, B, and C. Then you can see that there's the line count that tells you what the pattern is for each row. There is a total of 61 rows in this template, and then each row uses 62 rhinestones. So there's 61 rows in height and then 62 rows around. I also painted the tumbler. I used Color Shot acrylic paints, and I used them to blend in the colors so that it will help blend in any gaps that you might see after placing the rhinestones. So for the bottom part, I'm going to be using the Chameleon Rainbow. And I think I forgot to mention, I'm using the size SS16. So then I'm going to go ahead and get my stones ready to start laying the stones, and then I'll show you how to follow along with the template so that you are ready to go, and you'll be making one on your own in no time. So now that I have my stones ready to go, I'm going to go ahead and start applying my glue. I like to do my honeycomb patterns one row at a time. One of the most important things with a honeycomb is to make sure that you get your very first line straight. So I will lay my first row and then I'll turn it upside down and then I'll use my pickup tool and push all of the rhinestones so that they're flat with like the desk. So if I turn the tumbler upside down, I'll push them all down so that they line up with the desk. This ensures that that first row is straight. So now I'm going to go ahead and start laying my stones. So I'm at the point where on this first row where I'm going to start the color shift, I'm going to put the color B every sixth stone. So I'm going to lay six of the color A and then one of the color B. So to line this up too, because the pattern is on a six count and there's 62 stones in the row, it doesn't exactly go by six. So the very first part, the first one, you need to make sure you're following the pattern where you're going to only use four of the color A and then one of the color B, and then the rest of the pattern will follow that. So you'll have the first section will be four color A, one color B, and then the rest will be color A every sixth stone. So then I'm just going to go ahead and finish this pattern around the whole rest of this row. So then in this row, I'm going to do six of the color B, or five of the color B, and then one color A, because it's a six stone pattern. So five of the color B and then one color A for six stones in total. And then I'll just complete this around the whole rest of this row. Now I'm going to start on the second row. In the second row, I'm going to do the color A every fifth stone. But I do want to make sure that I line up at the same starting point where I used four of the color B and then one color A so that my pattern lines up. I want to keep it starting in the same spot. So then this part will be I'll do one of the color B and then a color A, and then I'll follow the pattern of a color B every fifth stone. So that alternate color every fifth stone. And so like the pattern for this row is just adding more of that bottom color to blend it in. So that you're going from a lot, you're gradually adding it in there to create that ombre effect. So then let me speed this up here a little bit so that we can show you the progression. I wish it really went this fast. I would say all in all, this type of tumbler, depending upon your skill and how many you've done, will probably take you at least 5 to 6 hours, if not longer. Now we're going to start on the third row of blending the colors. So for this row is really easy. This is just alternating the two colors. So it's one for one color A, one color B. And then you're just going to alternate that through the whole row. And then to make this row go faster, I tend to do all of the same color just so that then I'm not going back and forth to the different trays. So then I'm going to show you a little trick here too to keep your line straight as you're going along the cup. You can use things to stack up along the side of the cup and then use a pencil to make a completely straight line. So here I'm just using my rhinestone container and one of the trays flipped upside down to get it where I need. And then I'm going to use my pencil and I'm just going to stick out the pencil and I'm going to turn the tumbler all the way around. And then the pencil is going to make a completely straight line. And then I can use that line to make sure that as I'm going along, I'm keeping my line straight, and then you can make as many marks as you need. The more experience you get, you won't need the lines to keep your line straight. But as you're starting out, this is a good trick to use, and since you're using a pencil, that line, you're not going to see it after you place your stones. So then here you can see that with the pencil, you have a completely straight line all the way around the cup. So then you won't lay your stones right on that line. You'll just use it as a gauge to see if, like, maybe your row got a little bit off. And if it did, then you can make adjustments as you're going down the cup, to straighten your lines back up. So now we're going to go ahead and start on the fourth row. And for the fourth row, you're going to do four of the color B and then two of the color A. So then just make sure that you follow the pattern and you line up that first little section. But otherwise, it's going to be four color B and then two color A, the whole way around the cup. And then again, use your line that you had already made to make sure that your line is staying straight as you go around the cup. And then to keep the video moving, I'm only going to do a small section down the whole rest of the cup, just so that you can see the pattern come together. So then for the fifth row, this row is going to be an A, a B, an A, and then three B's. So it's A, B, A, B, B, B. All of the patterns are a six count repeating pattern. So you're going to have A, B, A, B, B, B. And also keep in mind the template is only a pattern to follow along. If you decide that you don't like the stone placement, or maybe you want your blending to be a little bit more, you can change it. Like, you don't have to keep it exactly like it shows on the pattern. You can make it your own. Now for the sixth row, you're actually going to do the same thing that you did in the row prior to that one. You're going to do four color B and then two color A. So you're basically just flip-flopping it, that row is going to be identical to the row one above it. So this one is four color B and then two color A. So now for the seventh row, you're going to do this one. You're going to put a color B every sixth stone, and the row below that, the last row, you're going to do a color B every sixth stone as well. But you're going to stagger your placement to where that color B is kind of like in the center. Like on the bottom row, it's kind of like in the center of where you have your block of the color B or color A. So again, just look at the pattern and kind of follow along the placement. If it's helpful, you can kind of lay out the stones before you put them on your tumbler, before you commit to putting them in the glue, to kind of see how it's going to lay out, and so that you get a little bit of practice laying them as well, and visualizing for yourself how the pattern's going to go ahead and lay out. And again, if you don't like that stone count, like as you're practicing, you can change it. Maybe you want more of the other color or less of the other one. Really, it's up to you on how you want to decide to do that. Now I'm just going to go ahead and finish up this last bottom section with all of the color, the Chameleon Rainbow Rhinestones, and then I will show you what the finished tumbler looks like. And I also have a two color ombre tumbler that I can show you as well. That pattern is also available too. So here is the finished tumbler, and don't forget, you can find everything that you need to create this tumbler on our website at blingyourthings.com. The tumbler kits include everything that you need to get started, and they are $15 off compared to purchasing all of the products that you need individually. And each kit includes enough stones to create actually two tumblers depending upon the style that you use. And then when you are on our website, don't forget to go over to our blog. You can also find another printable template for a two-color ombre tumbler. This one is very similar in the pattern. You're just using two colors instead of three, and then you're expanding that space that you're using to create the blend between the two colors. So I hope you have liked everything in today's tutorial. If you haven't, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel. And until next time, I hope you have a fabulous week.